This tutorial shows how to insert and modify text watermarks in Microsoft Word. Hello, my name is Erin. I'm a technical writer and editor who shares step-by-step software tutorials and writing tips for the real world on this channel and on my blog at erinwrightwriting.com. Last week, we added watermarks to PDFs with Adobe Acrobat. Inserting watermarks in Microsoft Word is more complex than in Acrobat, so we're going to divide the topic into three separate tutorials. In this first tutorial, we're going to look at how to insert text watermarks, how to modify text watermarks, and how to delete text watermarks. In the second tutorial, we'll insert, modify, and delete image watermarks. And in the third tutorial, we'll insert text and image watermarks on specific pages. I'll be using Word from Microsoft 365. These steps will also work in Word 2019, Word 2016, and Word 2013. However, your interface might look slightly different in those older versions of the software. Before we begin, let's quickly define watermarks. Watermarks are words, phrases, or images that identify ownership, indicate confidentiality, or show status. Watermarks are usually transparent enough to allow text and images to show through the mark. The following steps show how to insert built-in and custom text watermarks on every page of your document. To begin, select the Design tab in the ribbon. Then select Watermark in the Page Background group. Now select one of the built-in watermarks, which are Confidential, Do Not Copy, ASAP, or Urgent, or select Custom Watermark if you want to use your own text. If you chose a built-in option, it will appear in your document immediately. If you chose Custom Watermark, select the Text Watermark button in the Printed Watermark dialog box, and then type your custom text into the text box. You can then adjust the font, size, color, and diagonal or horizontal layout. Next, ensure that semi-transparent is checked if you want your text and images to be visible through the watermark. We'll look at how to modify the transparency further in the next section. When you're finished, select the OK button. The printed watermark dialog box should close and your text watermark should appear in your document. It's important to note that every time you add a watermark, it replaces the existing watermark. So if you want to replace your watermark completely, you can just repeat all the steps in the previous section. However, you can also modify the appearance of an existing text watermark. To begin, double-click the top of any page to open the Header and Footer tab. Although it may seem strange to open the Header and Footer tab, in Word, watermarks are connected to the header, even though they typically appear in the middle of the page. Next, hover your cursor over the watermark until your cursor becomes two crossed arrows. Then double-click to select the watermark. When it's selected, you'll see small gray adjustment handles shaped like squares and circles. This process can be a bit temperamental, so you may have to try more than once to select the watermark. Now select, hold, and drag the adjustment handles to change the size. To reposition your watermark, hover your cursor over it until the cursor becomes the two crossed arrows again. And then click, hold, and drag your watermark to a new position. Next, right-click the watermark with the crossed arrow cursor and select Edit Text from the shortcut menu. When the Edit Word Art Text dialog box appears, you can edit the text, font style, font size, boldness, and italics. Then select the OK button. For additional options, right-click the watermark with the crossed arrow cursor again, and then select Format Auto Shape Picture from the shortcut menu. In the Format WordArt dialog box, you can adjust the transparency. The higher the number, the greater the transparency. I encourage you to explore the rest of the Format WordArt dialog box, particularly the Fill Effect button, for additional customization options. When you're finished, select the OK button. The WordArt tab, which opens when you select your watermark, offers even more customization tools, such as shadow effects and 3D effects. When you're done customizing your watermark, select the Header and Footer tab, and then select the Close Header and Footer button. The changes to your watermark should take effect immediately. If you want to remove your watermark, select the Design tab in the ribbon, followed by Watermark in the Page Background group. Finally, select Remove Watermark from the drop-down menu. This removal process will remove all the watermarks in your document, including image watermarks. As always, remember to save your file to save your changes. I have created many other videos about Microsoft Word, including how to restrict style changes in Microsoft Word and how to restrict editing in Microsoft Word. Please see the complete list in the playlist titled How to Use Microsoft Word, which is linked in the description box below. The companion blog post for this video showing all the steps we just performed appears on erin.writewriting.com, which is also linked below. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic related to Microsoft Word or Adobe Acrobat that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss future tutorials, and give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.